Good afternoon, everybody, families, friends. And after just finishing about an hour and a half of workout of much needed activity, on behalf of myself, my family, Matt Brown, the Brown family, and an entire community affected by spinal cord injuries, we thank you for the opportunity to show you what we are able to do preparing for our 10th Boston Marathon and our 13th marathon overall. It is with great honor that we all sit here and watch what preparation is taken going into such an event as a marathon, especially the Boston Marathon.
Where they bury him?
In Jim's favorite spot. Right there under the bridge on the Ponce River. They buried so many bodies in that hole, it became known as the Bulger Burial Ground.
Hurry
up! You ever met a guy named Gary that was like,
no, dude, it's bizarre.
Okay. All right.
Big things a week before the Boston Marathon, and how do you feel? I honestly feel like I'm gonna take a when we go out of state, especially in New Hampshire, we're 2 for 2. I almost went to the starting line without my bib again. The Lion and the Wizard of Oz didn't have any cards. That's bullshit. Like, this is great. This is great. This is better than a line with no coverage. I'm feeling frosty, not with the tips, but I'm ready, man. This is great. Crush proof. This guy's got bare feet. I've never seen anything like it.
Hi-ya!
Fishing, baby.
Who's down with OPP? Every last lady!
I hope you love where you stick in this life.
I didn't have to take a sh**. That's pretty good. I feel pretty good, man. Another week to go. What are you so gassed for? Would you just run from there? Hey, listen. Breakfast. That's how we do it. So that's it. The training cycle for the 2024 Boston Marathon literally ends in New Market, New Hampshire at the Great Bay Half Marathon. So anyway, I have a feeling they built the railroad here, considering some of the dilapidation of some of the surrounding buildings. Just saying. Anyway, so yeah, it was a pretty good race. 1 hour, 49 minutes, But it was a good run. A week from tomorrow will be the 2024 Boston Marathon. For a lot of good reasons, this year it'll be Matt Brown and I's 10th marathon. The third for the Matt Brown Foundation. Correction, the fourth for the Matt Brown Foundation. Our 14th marathon, and there is nothing better than the scent of victory in the air. And I would always say, with a man in the arena, oh yeah. It's another beautiful morning. You know what they always say from those 1980s airline commercials? Fly those friendly skies, man. Today's one of those days.
Call me back. Yes, Jack. Let
me go get your
Hold
on.
What's up, kid?
Go get him, Clarissa. Go get him, Maddie.
Well done, Brian. We wish you Godspeed all the way. 69. All right. A hand clap of the business. It's Paul McHale there, heading to East Nebraska. Our duo right behind him. Doing the same. Once again, Rick and Dick Point pioneers of this sport in the duo category.
To be with this kid.
You want a sip?
Beautiful weather, huh?
Hey, right? A lot of better feel on the
Hey, right?
There's nothing. There's all the better feel on the Matt Brown Foundation.
Hey, what's this one?
Yeah, the casting purpose was to win.
That and why?
Because why the f not?
Alright.
Cheers, boys.
Cheers.
Alright, cheers. Let's go.
What do you want, the refund? No, you can't leave it here.
Don't see you in 2 hours.
Just got my breakfast. I feel good.
That's a full two-hander. That's one of these. And for how many?
One of these.
One of these. And three of these. That's a three-hander. That's 13 overall.
Okay.
Stand by.
Yeah. Okay. Now stop.
Nobody realizes the emotions to this sh**. Marathon might be over today. Be careful, an understanding human being never stops.
How you feeling, brother?
Hot,
huh?
Oh, he's good.
I did a small one this year, but I didn't think it was
it's not 40, but you can't do it a lot more.
You want to see something?
How you doing, Grace?
That's great, man.
Thank you.
Great time, man.
Hi, sweetie.
Thank you so much.
Great job, we'll see you.
Hey, man.
Ah, man.
I saw you. You saw me as a friend. I got a picture of you like from behind.
I'm so excited.
You got like a sunset, but like a hard way.
What?
I just met someone.
I'm not
like, how do you feel right now?
Hey.
Hey.
So I'm here with my friends. We all work together. GQ Magazine. She's my editor. She's my photographer.
In one.
In it.
We're in one.
Hi. Hi.
The group in this room has come here since 2012, and year after year it gets bigger and better. And so if we keep, you know, promoting the foundation and growing this thing, you know, more people are going to reap the benefits. So thank you. I'm going to hand off to Shannon to say a few words.
Last summer I ran the Falmouth Road Race for Matt, and I just absolutely loved it. We're the same age. We went to Stonehill together, graduated together. He was always a huge support. I think ever since graduating college together, we've just remained such constant support in our lives. And for some reason, I thought, hey, getting a bid for the marathon. Let's do this. I must have been on like the high for running. And he reached out to me come January and said, hey, the board liked your little entry narrative. It was very clear. I kept saying family. And the training was tough, but it is such a small detail to what Matt and everyone who is suffering from paralysis and living with that going through. It's such a motivating thing. So, doing my first and last marathon. So happy I will never get into double digits, let alone above one. But I, again, appreciate all your support in helping me reach my fundraising goals, help support Matt, and then just everyone's support in general towards the foundation. It truly means a lot to me and our family. So thank you.
Well done,
Karen.
Well done, Matt. Great job, Matt. Great job, Shannon, to our other two marathoners in the house.
Yeah.
Clarissa Modi and Madeline Adams.
Woo! Right here. Woo!
Boston College track athletes basically just tore the course up and left dust in their trail. Like Matt was saying, we've been here since 2012, and the people wearing the Matt Brown Foundation shirt, and you see the name on the front of it, and you see the name, and you come here to support this every single year. Look how much this has grown, right? Like, be proud of like what you got going on right now, because you are putting more effort in than anybody else who isn't here. So give yourselves a round of applause first. I came from a very patriotic family that taught me, literally, fight beside any man and die for any woman. And that's the way I walk and live my life today. And mom and dad, my mother and father are here. Wow. Thank you very much. For that. My nephew isn't here, and I just want to let everybody know it's been one of the most emotional training seasons of my entire life.
for a lot of reasons. And for me to sit here and say that my nephew Drew Carr is cancer free is wonderful. Little niece Ava will be probably watching her on TV one day playing a professional women's hockey league. Unlike her uncle's careers on the Oilers and the Islanders, maybe, that didn't amount to jack but literally that puts us in fraternity for hockey, which is the closest thing that makes our connection spark just a little bit more. And if anyone didn't see the interview last night on Channel 7, for the first time in 14 years, I couldn't keep it like inside or under my skin. I bawled my eyes out.
Yay!
I did, right? But like the whole thing, the outpouring of the support outside of what has been built is in like one of these things that just, look at everybody. We got Matt Brown attire. We got people here supporting the Matt Brown Foundation for our 10th Boston Marathon and our 13th marathon overall. And all I got to say is to everybody, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. The Brown family, thank you for picking up my phone call that day.
My
and look,
my
goal. Hey, Mike, and look where one phone call got somebody to where we are now. And I would say that this, by far, is the sweetest, right? I feel like we just won every major championship that the Boston, any Boston franchise just won in the last 20 years. So, right on. I got nothing else. I want everybody to enjoy themselves. And hold on one second. Matt's got one thing to say.
We all raised a glass, for everyone coming out for 10. A successful year, number 4, but we're not done yet. There's going to be more families, more individuals reaping the benefits of our efforts and your contributions. So let's enjoy this one, but we're not done yet. All right, thank you, everyone.
Thanks for your help, Matt.
Thank you.